It's in here.
Indeed. What? Me? Okay, if you say so. Instant movement, all right for some.
No time for glib remarks. Just keep trying to beat it.
Sail, it's a necromancer. Half of the monsters are summoned.
So all the monsters were being controlled by that necromancer. We have to stop it before we're surrounded. We can use this, Master Zael.
What is it?
A very special treasure. A little wall of ice will pose no challenge to the powers of this stone.
Looks like a Garak sunstone to me.
Exactly! Very astute of you. Go on, give it a try. I knew it! The exit should be up Huh? And what do we have here? A dead end?
Horace, no way!
I'm sorry, but I wasn't wrong. If you would look up, you'll see that it does indeed connect to the outside.
And who's gonna climb this?
Scholarly types do have a rather peculiar brand of humor, don't they?
Say, this place is really weird.
The whole chamber is steeped in magic. It must have taken a mage of tremendous power to make something like this. Oh.
What's up?
Ooh, an old book! Look at the script, it's ancient!
Lassilis Island. And there's a map of the island. I can't read anymore, I'm afraid. If only we had some kind of reference.
There are books in the castle from the time of the first count. Perhaps if we went to the library?
Either way, we can't stay here. Let's go back.
I honestly thought we might find an exit.
It's fine. We got some exercise. Better than being stuck in a cell.
True. Plus, I'm really looking forward to studying this book.
Is this really the time to be getting so excited?
Excited? I'm not the one who fell down a hole.
Master Zael, you take this sunstone. You could probably put it to better use than I could.
Judging their escape attempt a failure, Zael and the others return to their cell.
Wake up, you! Feeding time! How was I?
General Astor! You came to see us!
Therius told me everything. You've been through quite the ordeal. However, Master Dagran is working hard to clear your name with the Count. You must be patient.
Thank you for your concern.
Although I must say, bringing Lady Callista to the Gorak base was rather rash, wouldn't you agree? You must have had a reason. Won't you tell me?
I'm very sorry, General. I'm really grateful that you came here, but I can't.
It's fine, Master Zael. If you're so determined to stay silent, I think it's rather clear what's going on. In any case, you must not be so rash. Well, getting a little reckless now and then can be a good thing. Come, eat up. Let me know how it tastes. I do like to hear praise about my cooking.
What? Is that true?
If you would like, my lord, I can present you with all of the evidence.
You surely do not understand the significance of this yourself.
I can't say I haven't heard a few rumors, but I'm not so foolish as to try and dig through the secrets of a powerful man like you.
You are a wise man. But Lord Jural seems hell-bent on proving the boy's guilt. What can we do?
I just might have a few ideas, my lord.
Such as?
When are we going to get out of here? Seriously, it can't end like this.
Need booze. Need meat.
The guard came 3 times while you were away. Actually, he's really nice once you get chatting to him. He even forgot that you were gone. Isn't that nice?
So that's how you get all those girls to give you the time of day.
A lot's changed here since the current Count arrived. If anyone says a bad word against him, bang, you went...
I'm getting really hungry.
What's that?
time for more questioning. Come on!
Zael's inquisition continued as further testimonies were presented. Zael stood resolute, uttering not a single word as he waited for the final judgment.
Surely dragging this out any further is a waste of time. He won't defend himself. That is as good as a confession. I believe capital punishment is in order. I trust you agree, my lord.
Do you really have nothing to say?
Punish me if you have to. Just leave my friends out of it. Let them go.
My, how admirable of you. Very well, I have no objection to this. You're the only one I'm after. I couldn't care less about your filthy mercenary.
I do apologize. I know I wasn't summoned, but I thought I'd just poke my nose in. Oh, and I hope you don't mind, but I brought someone along who'd like to have her say.
Callista?
I have one thing I want to say to you all. The decision to go to the Garak base with this man and his friends was mine alone. They were worried about my safety. They told me I should return to the castle, but I wouldn't listen. I made them take me to the base.
I do not understand. Why would you knowingly put yourself in such danger?
Well, you see...
No, Callista. Don't tell them.
How goes the investigation?
Your lordship,
would you show me your hand? This could only be the mark of the outsider.
The what?
Allow me to explain. You see, there is a legend passed down in the Argonan family. When Lazulus Island is in crisis, a man with the mark of the outsider will appear as the island's savior. That savior stands before you today.
No. It's inconceivable.
Assuming I am correct, I need not tell you of the great significance this man could hold for us. In these dark times, he is a beacon of hope. Why would such a man ever think to kidnap Lady Callista? Lord Jiral, are you sure you are not somehow mistaken?
My lord.
Lord Jiral might be forgiven for making such an error of judgment. Such is his deep devotion to my niece. Isn't that right, Lord Jiral?
If you put it like that, my lord, you may be correct.
Then this is a cause for celebration. Not only do I have a wonderful future nephew in Jiral, but now also a brave warrior to defend my people. Lazulus Island is surely saved!
Then I declare the accused innocent of all charges. Take it, no one has any objections?
Master Zael showed true courage in the face of such torment.
I'm glad we made it in time.
Thank you, everyone.
He thinks he can disgrace me like that and get away with it.
He'll see.
He'll see.
Zale was free to go, his name cleared. It wasn't long before his friends in the dungeon were also released. After stretching their weary bodies and bathing in the sun's light, they all gathered in the great hall.
Good going, Zale. We've been acquitted.
My body's aching from that damn cell. I'm gonna sleep for a week.
But I wonder why they released us. Did they have a sudden change of heart?
I don't know. I can hardly believe it myself.
Who cares? We should be celebrating. I'm gonna drink till my arms fall off.
Yeah, but first I have to find General Astar and thank him.
So you're Zale. The General is waiting for you in the courtyard. Go now. The General asked for you himself. You should be honored.
Why, it's Master Zale. I'm glad your head is still attached to your body.
So am I, believe me. I can't thank you enough, General.
Me? No. Master Dagrin is the one who bent the Count's ear. I was only there for show in the end.
But you brought Lady Callista. That's what made all the difference. Jarral wouldn't have backed down otherwise.
Well, then you should thank the Lady herself, along with the others who helped win your freedom. All I did was lend Lady Callista a hand. How could I not, when I saw her deep concern for your safety? Zale, the truth is absolute, unchanging, but sometimes petty emotions drive people to distort the truth. And yet emotions can also drive people to seek it out. Those are the people you ought to treasure.
Yes.
However, if what the Count said is true, I fear our troubles have only just begun. That mark of yours represents an even greater power than I imagined. You must be careful not to lose yourself. Power is best used by someone with the strength of heart to wield it.
I'll bear that in mind.
You're Zale? The Count summons you to his chamber. Do not delay.
The Count?
Indeed. His chamber is on the second floor. Your friend Dagrin is already on his way.
Master Zale, the Count's chamber is one floor above. There will be some knights guarding the door. Please look for them. The Count...
Master Zale, the Count awaits you.
My lord?
Ah, just the man I was looking for. Now, about your right hand. Dagrin has briefed me, but I would like to hear the details from you. How exactly did you receive that mark?
Let me explain.
I see. This is a curious turn of events indeed. Why would it give you its power? Well, I'm sure we'll find out eventually. By the way, Lady Callista was worried sick about you.
My lord, I assure you that Lady Callista had nothing to do with this.
Settle down. If I fretted every time that girl went off on her own, why, I'd never have a moment's peace. Now that I think about it, perhaps it is fortuitous that you and Callista became so close. Depending on your answer, I might even reconsider her engagement.
My answer?
As you know, Lazulus has been like the sword of the Empire, fighting the Gorak and other foreign enemies for hundreds of years. Jiral and Callista's marriage would certainly give us great influence within the Empire. But it is only a means to an end. My true goal has always been to annihilate the Gorak and bring peace to the Empire.
But is that even possible?
It will not be easy, of course, but that power of yours may be the deciding factor. With your help, it might just be possible.
Mate, I don't know what you're frowning about. This is our chance. I doubt we'll get another one.
I know that. But I just... It's not me the Count wants. What he wants is... the power of the Outsider. Is that really a good thing?
That's none of our concern. If you think you can't handle it, you better get yourself sorted.
Just give me some time, Dagrin. I need to figure things out.
All right, then. Go and clear your head.
If you swear absolute loyalty to me, I will knight you and your friends. And if you so desire, even marrying Callista might not be out of the question.
Was that Callista?
No. Tell me she wasn't listening. I have to catch up to her. The thought alone.
Callista's room is that?
Through here are the guest rooms and the ballroom. Lady Callista went to her room looking very depressed. I hope she's all right.
Callista's not in her room. Where'd she get to?
Lady Callista just left. Said she wanted to feel the wind on her face.
She's not been kidnapped.
No, don't be stupid.
Don't just drop in. The Count may think you're innocent, but I know better.
You'll never be anything more than a mercenary. The life of nobility is not easy.
Callista? Callista? Not here either. Wait, Callista! Callista? Thank you. They declared me innocent because of you.
That's okay. You were protecting me as well. That's why you didn't tell them the truth, right?
Well, I...
Zael. Can I talk to you about something? I overheard you talking to my uncle.
What?
Please, you have to refuse his offer.
What? Why? We can... I mean, I haven't decided anything. But think about it. It would all be over. You wouldn't have to marry Jor-El.
You don't understand. There were people who did everything they could. People who saw the situation I was in and tried to help me. But my uncle or Jor-El would always find out. And something terrible would happen. So many people hurt because of me. Listen to me, Zael. I might not have a clue about the outside world, but I know this world a lot better than you do. It's not some fairy tale world of knights and princesses like in the stories. People cheat and murder for their own gain without batting an eyelid. There is no freedom here, only treachery and deceit. I don't want you to live in a world like that.
So what then? You'll just marry Jor-El. You're okay with that?
Of course not. I just can't let you get caught up in this, too.
The Outsider's Chosen One has appeared. Now this island will become the most powerful fortress in the world. The Empire, no. The whole world will be mine.
Zael, I have a message from your friends. They said they're going back to the tavern. They seem quite worried about you.